we're gonna go down and pick up this 10.5 foot long white ash log to load onto the sawmill. Paint on there so we know where the center of the log is.
Okay.
Or at least the CG for picking it up. I'll try to line right up with it.
Okay, I can put it there.
Okay.
Can we do it?
Yeah, you'll see the orange mark.
Yep.
This down a little so we can hook the chain as short as possible. Okay, that's perfect.
Okay.
Let's just slide it over like about a half inch, yeah.
I can get it.
Only has to go over a little bit. That's good right there. There we go, yeah. That's good. Doesn't take much movement on that tongs to
help.
Okay, I'm gonna go up. you can just tell me if I gotta go up a little, I can.
Yeah, up. Okay, that should be more than enough.
Okay, I'm gonna go down with it slow.
Okay. Okay, you want me to wedge it?
Yeah, that'd be perfect. Yeah, let me let it down a little bit. It's pretty heavy there.
Yeah. You want it to go this way?
Kind of would have liked to head the small end on towards the head, but I think it'll be fine.
It looks like it's resting on there pretty good.
Yeah.
Now, do you got to do the jack?
I got to.
We got to see what the center.
First.
Yeah.
Set up against the. Yep, she's up against the log stop. So. Okay. Well, we got the log loaded, and we'll get things measured up and see where we want to take the first cut. Okay, here what I'm getting ready to do is just measure where the pith is, and want to try to keep that level, especially on this first cut. Right now we're at 9.5 inches on the big end. And we're at a little over 9.5 inches. So I'm gonna jack that back end up a little. Gotta get the tools. Thank you. I'm going to do here is bring this end of the log up approximately a quarter of an inch, and then the pith will be level. Okay, we're good there. Gotta go up just a little bit more. There we go, 9 3/4 there. And 9 3/4 there. Okay, so now we got the pith level. Make sure she's against the log stops. Okay, she's good and solid. Now we'll get the engine warmed up and ready to make the first cut. Okay, I forgot to mention how long this log is, this white ash. Right now we're at 10 feet 6 inches long. On the large end we're 16 inches in diameter. And on this small end we're 15. So now what I'm going to do is start the engine on the sawmill and get her warmed up. Okay, first thing we got to do is turn the fuel on, put the choke on. We'll let that warm up for a few minutes, then we'll start opening this log up. Ready to make the first cut here to open this log up, and I went and changed my hat. I watch a YouTube channel called Frickin' Jeep, and I used to think John's hat was funny, but after cutting a few logs on this mill, now I know why he wears the hat he does. So thanks, John, for the tip on the hand. Okay, I'm going to run this for a minute and make sure I'm getting lubrication. see what that looks like. I want to bring the camera over and get a...
Okay.
Show you what this white ash looks like. Hopefully that's focusing okay. It's a nice log. Now what we're going to do is unclamp this and rotate it 180 and take another cut. Okay, we're going to unclamp this and make an attempt to roll this log over. I gotta unclamp this. Gotta take the tow board out here, drop that back down. This is just an old car jack, scissors jack I had, and I made a top for it so that it could, the log could rest on it. And that way we can level the pit with it. Okay, so now we're going to make an attempt to roll this over with the cant hooks. Okay, we're going to take our cant hooks here and we're going to roll this log 180 degrees. Okay, you ready?
Huh? Yep. Okay, mine.
Okay, get another bite on it.
Okay.
Ready?
Whoops, it's gouging this.
Okay. Let's push it back a little bit. That's good. Okay, that's good.
Okay, I think I'll clear it. Nope.
There you
there.
Go.
Now it will. Oh.
Just a little more.
Just a little more. This okay. Is our first time. Wow, yeah. Not our first.
Perfect.
There we go. Awesome.
So now we got her flipped over 180, so we'll get set up to make the next cut. Well, after we rolled this white ash log over, we wound up having a little friend down here. Got a little praying mantis. He's comfortably sitting on the log here. We'll take him off and put him in the field.
Hey,
You almost got it.
Come on. There you go. There you go, baby. Let's go.
There you go. We saved the praying mantis. They're good bugs to have around. We're going to make sure this is pushed up against the log stops, and I'm going to clamp it, and we're going to take the next cut. Okay, I'm just going to push this against the log stops. Make sure it's up against them. And get the clamps in. I will say I do like these log clamps on the Woodland Mills HM126 sawmill. They're like a cam action, and they really bite in there good. Been real happy with them. So now we're ready to open this side of the log. I did just want to mention what blades I was using too on this. There's a YouTube channel I watch called Out of the Woods. A fellow named Nathan Elliott, he highly recommended these blades from a fellow named Joe Main down in Georgia. So I've been buying the blades from him, and I've been really happy with them. They really do a nice job cutting, and they seem to hold their edge good. So, okay, we're going to take a slabbing cut here. I think we'll take another four-quarter board off of this just to get this cleaned up here. It's looking pretty nice. You got beautiful grain in there, though. see what we wound up with here. Okay, now we're gonna rotate it and square it up and keep slabbing.